The last thing that you're going to do to prepare to do this still life is you're going to take the best thumbnail that you have. You're going to draw an approximate 5x7 inch box and do a little study. The study can take anywhere from 20 minutes to an hour, which is still worth it because you don't want to get 8 to 20 hours into a still life and realize that you're just on the wrong track and it's something that you could have fixed early on in this stage. So even if you do a study and you don't like the study and how it turns out and you figure that you don't want to pursue that particular thumbnail for your drawing, you can just back up, pick a different thumbnail, and do another study. Even then, you're still at the most 2 hours into your planning time, which is totally fine. That's better than 8, better than 20. You want to be sure that you're on the right track with this. So with your study, you transfer the layout that you had in your thumbnail, you reobserve your still life, and you begin to add some value in there. You don't need to do a fully detailed drawing, and you don't have to worry as much about the structures and everything. So what you decided on in your thumbnail is how the composition is going to go. Your major decision here is where the major values are going to go. If you could do at least 5 different values, that would be ideal. The main thing that you want to do here is find your lightest lights, your darkest darks, and your largest areas of value, and kind of know approximately what they are. If you can eliminate the compositional decision and the value decision, the only stuff left on your large drawing to decide on are things like the exact structures of everything that you're going to do, which you've already practiced a whole lot by this point. You're going to decide on textures and marks and all the sort of fun things about drawing. You know, the deciding on the composition and nailing down particular values aren't quite as enjoyable as deciding how you're going to make marks sometimes. So this saves you a lot of time and a lot of effort on the back end here. So when you do this study, you do want to take some care with it. You want to stay loose, but you also want to be sure that you're putting down some right values, some correct values. And you definitely want to be sure towards the end to anchor down your darkest darks. Find where your absolute darkest points are. There should be about 3 or 4 in any given still life, even if they're very small. And then you want to be sure that if you've worked in the darks, like I have most of the time, that you go back through and you kind of make a couple of decisions about, on the light part, which is darker than, which areas of light are darker than others, so that you know what you're going to hit in the end.